I love WhatsApp because it lets me talk to my family for free. In fact, a couple of months ago, I made a video telling you guys how you can use WhatsApp on your computer. But back then, I preferred to use the app on my computer, and that has changed over the time. Here's why. So I like WhatsApp because it's just like Facebook Messenger, but it doesn't kill as much battery. It's like Facebook Messenger, but it's private. They need your phone number and stuff. It's like Facebook Messenger, but you can still look at the photos you shared without internet connection. It's like Facebook Messenger,
okay, but... Okay, that's enough, dude. Calm down.
I was going to say the color plays into the psychology, but okay. Using the app on my computer, I constantly dreaded the loading screen, you know? It's just loading all the time and I tried everything. I closed the app on my phone and I opened it again. Nothing. I changed to another Wi-Fi connection. Nothing. I made sure the computer and the phone are on the same Wi-Fi connection. Nothing. I even tried to close the app on the computer and reopening it. And guess what happened? The message that I sent got deleted. PNP software back in 2009 worked better than that. What's the point of having an app on your computer when it doesn't remember where you last left it? I was visiting a friend this weekend in Paris and I noticed that he uses WhatsApp on the browser. And I asked him why he does that and he said it's because it doesn't pop up when you open the computer, you know? Like, there's no app in your face. It's in your browser tucked away with all your other tabs. But then when I saw him using it, he never seemed to complain about that loading thing, you know, something that I've been dreading all this while. And I gave it a try for myself and it's much better on the browser than it is on the app. Alongside WhatsApp, I also use Android messages on my computer. In fact, I made a video about that as well. But if you've not seen that video, don't watch it. You were expecting me to say go watch it, right? Don't watch it. It's not well done. This one's better. I'm getting better at the way I speak to the camera. And back then I was really stressed, you know, it was a little robotic and now it's not. Anyway, the point is even Android Messenger has an app for the Mac. I had the same problem with the messages app, like with WhatsApp, it always kept loading. But now when I use it on the browser, even Android Messages works better. And the same rolls for Google Keep. I had a Google Keep app, but the browser works better. So here's my solution to all that loading problem, okay? Open WhatsApp web and Android messages on your favorite browser, Google Chrome, of course. Then right-click the tab and choose Pin. Go to the menu, then open Settings. Under Startup, choose Close where you left off. Now when you're done watching YouTube or whatever else you were doing on Chrome and you want to shut Chrome entirely, go for it. The next time when you open, it will open with WhatsApp web and Android messages pinned on the left side. You're welcome. So this is interesting, right? On smartphones, the apps work better than the browser version. And on the computers, the browser versions work better than the app. Although the app was made for the computer. Why is that? Food for thought. If you guys are using Windows computers or have a different experience with these web apps, please let me know in the comment section below. Because I've tested this extensively only on the Mac. Maybe your Mac behaves differently. I'm curious to know, how does this pan out for you? For me at least, the browser version is way better than the app for these web applications. Thank you so much for tuning in, guys. I'll see you guys next week with another video on all things tech. And in the meantime, keep learning. When I was trying to pin this tab, it says send to the phone, something over here. When I click it, it says that it's trying to send something, but on my phone, there's nothing. I can't wait for that to work. The tramway in Lille is shut, you know. They are doing the repair work in the summertime and it's only going to open up tomorrow. And until then, you're free to walk over here. That's why I was shooting the video right in front of the tramway station. But the cars were kind of noisy. But I'm happy. This place is so beautiful. If you visit Lille, if you visit the north of France, you should stay in Lille for a couple of days. These streets are just so dreamy. Just
One stop down that way or 5 minutes by walk is my favorite bakery where you get some incredible pain au chocolat. So all the teasing with this, the pain au chocolat that I purchased in the morning is one stop away there. This place is really beautiful.